friends, Miss Lily here. Today is our last class in Art as Encouragement. It has been such wonderful fun leading you through these art projects to express gratitude and appreciation for people making a difference in our communities. Today, we're going to create a gratitude art project just for you and your family. We will be making a gratitude tree out of brown paper bags. Here it is. If you don't have a brown paper bag, you can ask your mom, dad, or someone in your family to ask for a paper bag next time they go to the supermarket or grocery store instead of plastic. What is a gratitude tree? It is a tree from which you will hang little slips of paper like these, on which you will write things that you are thankful for. There are so many things and people to be thankful for. I am thankful for my family and my pets, for fruits and vegetables, for art and music, for being healthy, for birds singing outside my window, and for the honeybees in the hive behind my house. My hope is that you will make this gratitude tree and invite everyone in your family to add what they are thankful for. Did you know that when you start thinking about all the good things in your life, like lasagna and video games and the sunshine and amusement parks, the anger and the sadness you may feel zaps away, and it is replaced by a feeling of well-being. That means that you feel good. Okay, so let me stop talking and let's get started. But before I go, I want to thank you for taking part in this series and ask you to always try to keep an attitude of gratitude in your heart. All right, let's get started. You want to begin by cutting strips of paper all the way down to that first fold line. And when you cut your strips, you want to cut them on an angle so that the top of each strip is thinner than the bottom, the same way that trees are thicker at the base and they taper to the tips. As you can see, I'm speeding this up so that you won't have to watch a 20-minute video. The paper is very stiff, so we will be scrunching it up once I'm done cutting to soften the paper. I got this idea from Amira. Thanks, Amira, who took paper and was telling me how you could take paper and turn it into toilet paper, regular copy paper, by scrunching it up a bunch of times. Okay, once we're done here, the thing we want to do is we want to gather all our strips and pull them together. And then we want to push down and mold a base. Just like a tree has roots, we want to create almost like a base and a root system. And I taped it down for now to create the shape. And see how I'm scrunching it down? Then I'm going to softening up that paper so that we can twist it more easily. Then I begin my twisting. Here I am twisting, and make sure that you twist the tips nice and tight so that they're thinner at the base. Now, as you can see, some of that market basket, some of the words, you can fold it so that you can hide the red and colors of the supermarket logo. You don't have to do that, but if you don't want it to show, that's what you do. And you're going to twist. As you can see, I'm twisting away.
Hi,
happy with the ends of your tree, you can use the old bits that you cut off from tapering and twist them. Twist them into sub-branches. Remember, when you look at a tree, it's not just one branch, but a bunch of little sub-branches come off the tree. The more sub-branches you put on this tree, the more realistic it will look. Okay, time to take our colored paper and to cut it into strips onto which we will write our list of things we are grateful for. So as you can see, I'm folding and cutting, and it's getting harder to cut the thicker the fold. So if it's easier for you, just cut your strips by page, that's fine. The other thing is you want to cut lots of strips because I'm sure there's lots of things you're grateful for, but also if you want to make this a family gratitude tree, you can share it with your siblings or your mom and dad. Now, when you're cutting, I'm cutting these strips and they're kind of long. So one of the things to do is you can keep some strips that are long and some you can cut in half. And the reason is, with some of them, you'll be able to fold them over the tree branches. And with others, you'll be able to maybe just write something short, like here, Mom. And then, what am I writing here? Baby the dog. That's my doggy. And then, let's see. Let's do a long one. This one is going to say, all my koi fish. With an exclamation point. Okay, time for the easy part. Folding your gratitude slips and putting them over the trees or pasting them down. So see with the long strips how it's just easy to fold them over the branches, whereas the short ones, friends, you can just paste on the tips or all over the tree. I hope you enjoyed this art project, and please share images of your art project with the Essex Art Center so they can post it on their Facebook page. Take care, friends. Making a gratitude heart. For this class, Supplies you will need are white copy paper or white cardstock, pencils, scissors, black and red markers, coloring pencils, or crayons, which are optional. Begin by folding your piece of white paper in half with the open side pointing away from you. Draw a half a heart and then cut it out. This should give you a symmetrical, that means even on both sides, heart. Draw a dot where the two round parts meet and use a straight edge, whether that be a ruler or the side of a book, to draw lines. Draw lines that are not too long, then put little dots on the edges of those and use those to make more lines. And keep drawing lines all around. They don't have to be even. You can make them even, but it looks more fun, I think, when you have lines that are going in different directions and are different lengths and angles. As you can see, I'm putting little dots where I end my lines to go in a different direction. All right, we're almost there. There you go. Next, you begin to color them in. Color them in different colors. You can use rainbow colors. You can use, if you like blues, you can shade them all in different shades of blues or pinks and reds or greens. Whatever combination you like. You could even do rainbow. And try to make your coloring even and not too dark, so that we're going to put words in these. So if you put it too dark, then the words, you won't be able to see the words too well. So keep your colors light. I try to use pastel shaded colors, but you can use darker colors. Just don't press down too hard. So continue coloring. Next, begin going over your lines that you created with your ruler or edge of a book with a marker. I chose black because I think it really makes the bright colors pop and gives it a nice dramatic flair, don't you think? But you may use any color you'd like to divide all the segments in your heart. Next, begin writing words. You know, words, they can be anything you'd like. I wrote, thanks a million, kind, generous, I appreciate all you do. Hero, helpful, grateful, inspiring, brave, thanks, kind. You can also leave some blank spaces. A gratitude heart.